Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Zoo Tycoon Diaries, the Challenge Zoo. It is me, Ruffy993. And in the last episode, what happened? I don't remember. That was the previous episode. We only did one challenge, I believe. And we got the Species Diversity Fund, which was impressive with our photos. Took three photos. One of a crocodile, one of an okapi, and one of an emperor penguin. Hence our new penguin exhibit here. So, because we have... Because we achieved five successful... No, not that one. This one. There we go. This button. Five successful photo challenges. I think for the next few episodes, in order to kind of wrap up this little mini-series, I'm going to only be focusing on game challenges and the endangered species challenge we have yet to do. Also, an interesting thing to note, while off-screen... While playing other files of the game, I actually unlocked the desert theme buildings, which you can do if you do the campaign for the African Adventure expansion pack of the game. It's actually pretty easy. It's one of the easier ones, in my opinion, to do, which basically you just... Oh, perfect! Oh my gosh, this is the perfect one. Okay, Endangered Species Challenge. The Endangered Animals Alliance would like some photos of endangered species using enrichment objects, which it will post on its website. I'm not sure why web is capitalized. If you can provide the Alliance with the right photos, your zoo will receive a free tiger swing enrichment item as compensation. The Alliance would like you to take the following photos. A giant sable antelope taking a salt lick. We can do that. We have some antelopes. A young komodo dragon in a lookout post. I can do that. And a gray wolf eating a beef shank. So actually, this is a pretty easy photo challenge. Unless you have, I believe it's the extinct animal expansion pack. It's really strange. The Extinct Animal Expansion Pack puts a lot of glitches into this game, which are really unfortunate, and one of them does affect this challenge, primarily taking a picture of a young komodo dragon on a lookout post. But when we get to that, I'll tell you how to avoid that glitch, and you can still complete this challenge even if you already have all the expansion packs downloaded into your game. Also, yes, the African Adventure campaign is super easy. It's just like, oh, have so many African species and that sort of stuff. It's not overly challenging. Like, get 5-star zoo. Like, the Great Panda. I also did the Mysterious Panda campaign, which got me this gilded statue of a panda, which I'm not sure was worth it. I spent so many hours on that trying to get it done, but ugh. But okay, alright, so photos. So let's tackle on the task at hand. We need a giant sable antelope. There's a little one. Does that count? Or does it have to be an adult? Where's even our salt lick in this thing? What are you doing? I'm going to drink water from the food trough. Do you have a mate? You have to have a mate. Waiting to nurse the little antelope. I don't think the little antelope was aware of that. Oh, Jaguar wants to reproduce. No. I deny it that. Actually, nah. Let's release it into the wild. Woohoo! We're paying for us. So let's see here if we can get one of our antelopes to go to the salt lick. I think, yeah, salt lick's right there. So maybe this guy will. Because what else do they do? They basically just eat, drink, and run around, and when the stimulation gets high enough and the food gets high enough, they'll go lick a salt lick. Oh, and perfect! I was going to check while we're waiting for our antelope to possibly go to the salt lick if we have the species available. We do. There's komodo dragon right there and the gray wolf, so hopefully that should be quick. Alright, both of them are giants and antelopes. There's a third one? I thought I definitely said going to fight the number three. Oh, that is number three, I suppose. Okay, we'll just build an exhibit for the gray wolves and a spat everywhere, and the komodo dragon, so we can get that underway. So I am going to do that. Alright, so I'm just gonna... There's our gray wolf exhibit. There's no gray wolves in it at the moment. Oh, we can release our secondary bird too from his crate, since the other bison has grown up. But let's just see if any of these guys... You're pooping. What are you doing? Going to use a salt lick. Okay, we'll just wait for this guy here, or female, I suppose. Wait for this gal to come take a lick at the salt lick, and we'll get that photo underway. But actually, what I thought is we have to get a young komodo dragon to climb the lookout post. So, we're going to have to get them to mate, although I'll see if I can do the kind of what you would do if you had the glitchy expansion pack. Giraffe, don't you get in my way. Awesome. So there's our first one. But actually, let's add ourselves some gray wolves. Those guys are always cool, too. Gray wolves, too, in my opinion, when putting them in your zoo, You initially start off with a couple, but these wolves will kind of behave similarly to real wolves in the wild, in that after, if you add another male or another female afterwards to get them to, like, encourage second-generation mating, often they will die due to the alpha killing them. It's kind of crazy. Or, like, they will become the alpha of the pack and kill the existing female or male. I've had it happen quite a few times with my gray wolves, as well as, oh my gosh, what are you giving us? What's this one for? This one? This one? Oh, maybe, I think it's this one. It receives a 5-star rating for our tour. Sweet. Okay, so I didn't put any meat in these guys' exhibit, because I'm going to put a beef shank and hope that will spur them to eat it. And then afterwards, we can put in a proper meat or fish inside of it. Going to eat the beef shank. Perfect. We're going to actually get some decent pictures instead of me just PC... No. Yeah, PC spacebar. That's usually what I do, right? The button combination that I use. There we go. Yummy, yummy. Perfect. So that's 2 photos down already. And actually, before I build the komodo dragon exhibit, actually, I'll meet you guys when I'm done building the komodo dragon exhibit, as well as a little food court area for the people who come this way. Okie dokie. So I kind of did a little brief little food court, little exhibit, and kind of did some upkeeping in other parts of my zoo, releasing animals and whatnot. Okay, so what we have here is we need to get a picture of a komodo dragon, a young komodo dragon, mind you, on a lookout platform. Which, do we even have a lookout platform researched for? I'm not even entirely sure. But let's get ourselves a male and a female komodo dragon. Now, let's see here. What would usually happen is, let's see, these guys have the lookout posters. Ah, I don't know. Habitat enrichment. What's that? Oh, we represented all the world's biomes. Go us. Okay, we do. Lookout posts. So when the komodo dragons are young, they are agile enough to climb up these things. However, these guys are not young. They're big, they're bulky, they're fat and lazy. They aren't going to climb it. But as I was saying, in the Extinct Animals expansion pack, what will occasionally happen is there's a glitch in there that results in either... The komodo dragons will never mate. Like, they always say they're gonna go mate, but it never actually happens. Something always distracts them. Or the young is conceived, produced, hatched from the egg, but it will never climb one of these things. So what the way to get around it is to actually take a picture of, I believe, any komodo dragon with the actual lookout post. I'm gonna try that here. No, and it doesn't seem to work. But it might be a young, because sometimes too what will happen is that the young komodo dragon, during the glitch, will walk towards the lookout post, but it won't actually climb it. And I think actually that also works for it, is if you get a picture of the young komodo dragon saying, oh hey, I'm going to go look at this post, or I'm going to go investigate it. That might be what we have to do. We might have to wait for one of these guys to investigate the lookout post. And I believe actually that is what will trigger the picture to be correct. So ignore what I said previously, but just being with the lookout post, we have to wait for the komodo dragon possibly to investigate the lookout post. So we'll see if any of these guys do that, and we'll try to snap a photo again of them doing that. Oh, they're gonna go greet each other. That's always a good sign. Be friendly with one another. Mate. Komodo dragons are actually pretty cool for being like large. They're kind of creepy though. At the same time, I won't lie. My dad's actually pretty good with most, like, gruesome things on, like, wildlife documentaries and stuff. Komodo dragons, he can't stomach. They are kind of vile, the way that they're, like, well, actually, what do they say? Komodo dragons' bacteria is what happens, that they get such bad infections in their prey, and that's what kills them. That might be part of it. Their mouths are pretty bacterial-filled. And definitely infection is prone to happen if one of these things bite you. But these guys also do have venom glands. They do. So they can inject venom into their bites as well as, you know, letting their bacteria that live in their mouths do all the dirty work for them. Doesn't matter. If you get bit by one of these, they also have sharp teeth. It's probably going to hurt. So I would advise, don't agitate one of these guys. Oh yeah, something else with these guys too, it seems to be glitching now as it did before when I tried to do this, is that it'll be like, oh, they're gonna go sleep in the burrow, or they're gonna sleep underneath this heat lamp, and they always like change their minds at the last moment and go and sleep somewhere else in the shade generally, and it's kind of silly, but these guys sleep all the freaking time. Oh my goodness. They sleep so much. Being reptiles and all, they gotta conserve their energy, I suppose. They just sleep in different spots all the time. Oof. Unfortunately, there's not too many endangered species challenges. Like, I can only think of 3 or 4. So, if you find one like this, it's kind of key that you do it. Unfortunately, it just takes... You don't even need to sleep. You have good privacy and you have good sleep. I don't understand why they're sleeping all the time. Do something. Do something interesting. Going to investigate the food dish. How about you investigate this? To see if this is the right theory. Oh, you're gonna go drink the water from the food dish now. Okay. Yeah, these guys take a bunch of little power naps or something. I don't really get it. All they do is they sleep, 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 sleep. There's not really even a point of putting in enrichment items, realistically. Because all they do is freaking sleep. But at least they move quickly for reptiles. Well, really, it's only the turtles that move really, really slowly of the reptiles. Which can be a problem sometimes. These guys seem to get around pretty well. So they flop their body around. Very traditional reptilian walking style, where they kind of bow side to side at the spine, instead of mammals, which go up and down as they walk. So yeah, these guys, they sway their hips. Fancy. Are you guys greeting each other? You're looking at the food dish. Oh, you just completely pushed them out of the way. Good, greet each other. Become mates. Let me guess, you're gonna go sleep now that you've done everything, right? Oh, you're going to poop! There's a new revelation. Let's put a lizard in there, see if you guys get active at all. You're standing. Oh, jeez, look at him flail about. Did you get it? Oh, no, it's way over there. Flop, 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 flop. Ooh, vicious sounding. Magic. It killed it through a tree. That's the real power of a Komodo dragon. Ooh, they stepped with their relationship. They are now going to be groomed by each other. Oh, things are getting pretty serious in the Komodo dragon world. Oh, that one's waiting to mate. You dipshit, don't you dare. Mate with her. Oh my gosh, no. Why do I have the glitch too? Why do I have this glitch? Oh, I do have the glitch. It's still in here. Why? Oh, you stupid Komodo dragons. Okay, even though I don't have extinct animals, which I was told this glitch occurs in, my Komodo dragons are still being buttheads. She was waiting to mate, and he was all walking around totally ignoring her, which usually happens. The males will ignore the females' responses to mate. So we'll just try it again, I suppose, and if not, I might have to go somewhere with internet connection and figure out why you're sleeping right in the middle of the tree. There you go. Oh, you're gonna go greet her, but you're not gonna mate with her. Yes, there we go. Okay, so my Komodo dragons are not mate, but I brought in a new one, and like her first instinct was to investigate the lookout structure. And that is what you need to do in order to get over the glitch. I did have the glitch in my game. My Komodo dragons were not mating, but now it doesn't matter. We got the free tire swing enrichment item. You'll find the swing in a crate near the entrance of your zoo. Cool beans. Actually, let's remove that Komodo dragon because she'll probably get killed or something. So we don't want that to happen. We don't want people sad because our animals are dying. I don't want my animals to die, for that matter. But here's our tire swing. Unfortunately, nope, that's a tire swing. Unfortunately, this is an animal enrichment object, but we don't actually have any animals that will play with this. Perhaps that means we shall get an animal that would play with that. Let's see, our primates are just, yeah, it's a primate. A primate toy. Do I have any primates? Oh, yay! We got our endangered species! Freaking things! Our themes and objects and buildings. These ones look super cool. Oh my gosh. Let's look. I'll show you. Look at them. They're so, like, tropical. Like, they're jungle-themed. Tropical rainforest-themed. I think that they're better. They're more, like, foliage-y and, like, actually more rainforest looking versus, what's the right word, versus ruins looking. And I love the little waterfalls and stuff on it. I think this bathroom here has waterfalls along the back too. Like, look how cool that looks. Ew, what if that was like black water and gray water coming out of that? Ew, nope. Though I want to believe that it's good water. But yeah, here we have a little our little stands and such. What else do we got? We have the archway of these two gorillas. The music rock, which always sounds cool. I love this fountain too. I don't know what's on it though. I think it's a leopard or something. Maybe like a black panther. Those are the ones that we can adopt in this game. The black panther versus a leopard of some kind. But yeah, I don't think we have any. No, we don't have any orangutans or apes or anything. Maybe I can do that. Lord knows I got the money. Maybe I should not put any new exhibits until. Well, there's any more unless it's something that has to be required of me. Just in case, I don't have very much space left in the zoo, and I don't really want to, like, remove animals from already existing exhibits, because I don't like doing that. That way we have enough space for more exhibits if we need to add, you know, add some gorillas for a certain thing, or someone's going to give us some gorillas, and we know that's a game challenge that we have to do. So that's basically all you have to do left, is just two more game challenges. Game challenge. Ooh. I don't think I've ever seen this one before. The Rainforest Coalition is preparing a series of newspaper ads that promotes awareness of rainforest wildlife and its endangered habitat. Okay, that's pictures. I don't want to do pictures. What do they want pictures of? They like to provide them with pictures of rainforest animals doing specific things. If you can get the picture, the Rainforest Coalition will pay you 10 grand. In addition, the publicity generated by the ads may make your zoo more popular. They're interested in photos of a jaguar cub pouncing, a chimpanzee eating fruit on a banana tree, and a Bengal tiger resting on a tropical rainforest rock. Difficult challenging. I'm actually not going to accept this because I want game challenges. I don't want any more photo challenges. So as sad as that may be, we won't see that one being done. Plus it's challenging. We already did a challenge for this episode. And I'm kind of running out of time for recording, but I want to get like a kind of a short and simple one if I can. I probably won't. If the next challenge doesn't look like one that will fare us well either, I'll just cut the episode off and we'll do more challenges in the next episode. I don't want any freaking photo contests. I'm thinking. Maybe since we already got all the photo challenges done, we'll accept this as a game challenge. We'll experiment with this, because this doesn't look very difficult. Wildlife Magazine is running into a photo contest that will pay 2 grand for each photo they run in their magazine. The contest ends in 2 months, so Wildlife Magazine will pay you for each photo you've successfully taken during that time. The specific photos required are a single photograph containing 3 common zebras. We can do that. We have zebras. A photo containing of 2 graded flamingos and a hippopotamus. We can do that. A photo of a Nile crocodile in the water, we can do that, and a photo of a red kangaroo thumping its tail. Difficulty moderate. So let's see if, hypothetically, this will work. It's listed under photo safari challenges, not actual game challenges, though. So I don't know if this is going to count towards it or not. Oh my gosh, it terrified me. I thought it was thunder, but I think it's a car. Alright, do I have 3 zebras in my viewfinder? I do. There's one photo. A Nile crocodile in the water. Where are my crocodile exhibits? Crocodiles! There they are. There's one of them in the water. There he is. In the water. Cool. Okay, red kangaroo thumping its tail. Actually, you know what? Because these Komodo dragons aren't going to breed, we're going to replace this exhibit with kangaroos because it's the same environment. That's what I was trying to say. Oh, kangaroo. First one there. Come on, can we get the other 2 that we need? Huh? Maybe? Probably not? No. I see little hippopotamus, but that's not a big hippopotamus. We need a big one. Not an itty-bitty one. But okay. There's kangaroo. I believe they thump their tails when they are dirty. That makes it sound so wrong. But, oh, global achievement. We got animals from every major. Well, maybe not major, because this includes South America. But we've got North America, Australia, Asia, and African animal. That's cool. But let's give it some stuff that it needs. We'll just wait for it to thump its tail. as I bring up, let's give it a female too. Excuse me, as we bring up, hopefully, the other animals that we need. Oh, there's our flamingos. So we'll be able to make that exhibit soon. If we get the hippopotami. Oh, and there's a hippopotamus. Perfect. I'm going to say we're going to have this photo challenge done super fast. As soon as, like, the difficult part of this is just getting one of these guys to thump their tail, because it's an action you have to wait for, but I don't think it takes very long for it to happen, thankfully. Yeah, I'm not sure if it's a social, a hygiene, or a stimulation thing for these guys to start thumping their tails. Or maybe a combination of both. I'm not entirely sure. Oh, what do we get? Congratulations, you've received Exemplary Entertainment Award for earning more than 100 grand in animal donations. Woo! Go us! That's fine. We can build our wetland exhibit here with hippopotamus as well as flamingos. We need two hippos and one flamingo. Two great flamingos and one hippo. I think I said that right. I really don't know, to be honest with you. One hippo. Two flamingos. Oh, two flamingos. There. Yeah. Alright, so yeah, just the last photo that we need. That is all. That should be easy to do. I'm glad you guys are getting along. You're thumping your tail! You bastard, that better not count. Yes, it did! Okay, so Wildlife Magazine loves your photos. They also recognize achieving such a unique collection of photos in such a short time with no small accomplishment. And have presented you with the Wildlife Magazine Amateur Photographer Award. Congratulations on your achievement. Score! Okay. Does that count as a game challenge now? That's the next question. I'm going to give the game a little bit of time to acknowledge that I did that. Clean the crocodile. Oh, we got our award there. There, so since that award got registered, stop doing that. Return to the game. Let's see here if that counted towards a game challenge. It did not. Okay, so in the next episode, I'm calling it quits here. We are going to do two game challenges only. No photo challenges because they don't count. So thank you guys for watching for this episode of Zoo Tycoon Diaries, the Challenge Zoo, and I'll see you in the next episode.